Well, when I was a kid, I sought out. I went to a lot of folk festivals and tried to learn and meet as many of the surviving older blues players at that time. You know, way back in the early 70s, and met Big Joe Williams. You know, Elizabeth Cotton. Bo Diddley came later. You know, I met Bo Diddley and Chuck Berry. I think a lot of my style is based on a Piedmont style, which is all, you know, an alternating thumb, bass line, and lead with the fingers. And a lot of the early records, like I was saying, Blind Willie McTell, Reverend Gary Davis, some of the people I've met, like Muddy Waters, Big Joe Williams, Browning McGee, influenced me a lot, Mississippi John Hurt. I tend to lean more to the Piedmont and the ragtime sound than I do the later stuff, although I can play all of it.
Dave Marash. I'm a correspondent for ABC News Nightline, and I'm a confirmed Ben Andrews fan of, I guess, close to 15 years standing. But let me tell you the thing that really knocked me out about town. I travel a lot, so there tend to be long periods, months at a time, where I will not hear Ben. And I found every time I would go away for 3 or 4 months and come back and hear Ben, I would hear something new. Ben is a guy who has consistently grown as a player, and even more particularly as a singer, over the 15 years. And every time I hear him, he is not only different, but he's better than the guy I heard before. And that's a really rare quality. And I think it testifies, one, to the sort of dedication and seriousness of Ben's art, but also to his real creativity as a musician.
Excited about playing every night with Ben because it's always good. I sat in with him about 8 years ago, and he was serious. First guy I seen play blues serious in the area, that, you know, like popcorn. And so we've been together ever since. Digging.
Well, I'll tell you, one time, the most interesting, we played a place called Zeno's up in Penn State. The whole room had quieted down. People that probably couldn't even see us were quiet. And it actually startled me that I'm just getting into it. And then suddenly this throng of people, the whole room erupted at one time. And of course, any other point in the night, half the people in the room couldn't hear us. That was a high point, to find that all those kids, college age kids, who normally, unless we're jumping around screaming something by Nirvana or whatever, they might not catch what we're doing, but they did that night. It was quite a treat.
I think the blues, if you try to play it exactly the way you would hear it or the way it was recorded on the older albums, that's not really what the blues is about. Because then you're not interpreting, you're preserving, you're more of a preservationist, you know. But I think true blues is a constant evolution and change within the realm of a certain format. And blues is a very close realm, unlike jazz, where you can really take it to extremes, because you have to keep it within that format to keep it blues, you know. And certainly it has to have a feel for it. Thank you.
I'm an easy rider, baby, where you been so long? Where my easy rider, baby, where you been so long? Turned my heart, ran to the rising sun.